Hey folks, welcome back. In this video, we're going to go over three worked examples to show you how to do problems involving Ohm's law. Now, if you haven't already done so, check out my previous video covering the theory on this topic, and that way you can apply what you learned in that video to this one. So let's get started. Question 1 says that an LED operates with a current of 15 milliamps flowing through it. If the resistance of the LED is 120 ohms, find the potential difference, i.e. the voltage, across it. Well, writing down what we know from the question, we're trying to find the voltage V. We know that current I is 15 milliamps, but remember we need to convert this into amps, so that's the same as 15 times 10 to the minus D amps. And lastly, our resistance R is 120 ohms. Now, writing down our equation relating voltage, current and resistance that we can get from Ohm's law, we get V equals IR. Substituting in the numbers, we get 15 times 10 to the minus 3 times 120, and putting that into your calculator gives a final answer of 1.8 volts. Question 2 says that an electric heater is connected to the mains, which has a voltage of 230 volts and draws a current of 7 amps. Find its resistance. Well, this time we're trying to find resistance R. We know that the voltage V is 230 volts and the current I is 7 amps. So writing down our equation, we have V equals IR. Rearranging this time for R, we can divide both sides by I, so we get R equals V over I. And substituting in the numbers now gives us 230 over 7. And putting that into your calculator gives a final answer of 33 ohms. Lastly, question 3 says that a kettle is connected to the mains with a resistance of 25 ohms. Part A says what current flows through it? Well, the first thing here that we should be aware of is that it says mains, so that is actually telling us the voltage, so the voltage of the mains is 230 volts, remember. So writing down what we know, we're trying to find the current I, we know the voltage V is 230 volts, and the resistance R is 25 ohms. So writing down our equation, we have V equals IR. Rearranging this time for I, we can divide both sides by R to get I equals V over R. Substituting in the numbers now gives us 230 divided by 25, and putting that into your calculator gives a final answer of 9.2 amps. Part B says if the kettle is switched on for 2 minutes, what quantity of charge flows through the element? Well, writing down what we know, we're trying to find the charge Q. We know that the current I is 9.2 amps from part A, and the time is 2 minutes. So we need to convert 2 minutes into seconds here, so 2 times 60 gives us 120 seconds. And writing down our equation relating Q, I and T, we get Q equals IT, and substituting in the numbers now gives us 9.2 times 120, and putting that into your calculator gives a final answer of 1.1 times 10 to the 3 coulombs. That's all for this video, folks. I hope you found it useful. If you did, give it one of these, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.